My name is Kevin Pirries, and today I'm going to do a quick little series that I want to start, you know, called Did You Know? And so we'll see where this goes, but just quick little snippets, just a couple of minutes, and then that's it. So I'll try not to talk too much this time. So this one's going to be about the OTDR, and so I'm going to talk about how you can edit an event within the OTDR software from EXFO. So I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to my OTDR, then I'm gonna switch over to a different camera here. And so essentially what I have here, in fact, I'm gonna switch to several different cameras here. I already shot an OTDR trace, right? So within this OTDR trace, here's my launch. So if I zoom into my launch here, you'll see that I have this little event here at number two. What is this? What is this event? Looking at the software, or looking at the event table, it says at 20 meters, I have a 0.29 dB attenuation, but no detectable reflection. Within the OTDR, under test configuration over here to the right, under test configuration, if you go into there, we have this setting called reflection detection threshold. So what this means is during analysis, any reflection that's better than minus 72, don't call it a reflection, don't show it to me. This is to help kind of clean up some of the noise. Any splice loss better than .02, don't call it an event. That way we're not picking up background noise. That's essentially what this is here. So this reflection must be better than minus 72. And so what is this? This is actually an APC connection here. So APCs can sometimes look like non-reflective events. And the OTDR doesn't know any better. It knows to look for reflection at a certain value. If it doesn't see it within that value, it's gonna call it non-reflective, which is what this symbol here means. And then it'll do pass-fail based on non-reflective events, which is splice loss. So this is a failed splice, but it's not a splice, it's a connector. So I can change this. So if I highlight this, in fact, let me move my face again here. So sorry about that. So if I were to get in here and highlight this event number two here, I can highlight this event number two. You'll notice there's a little pencil icon over here to the right. The little pencil icon over to the right there. I'm gonna go ahead and select that. And this will allow me to edit or change the properties for this event. This is not a non-reflective event. This is a reflective event, a connector, right? If you have other things like say a splitter or something that's positive, what do you mean positive? Gainers. So mode field diameter mismatch stuff. So you can define it and then these will have different values. So if I call it reflective, I'm gonna call it reflective here and then I'm gonna go ahead and modify it. And I can add a comment in here if I want to as well. So I can add a comment in here and say, this is an APC connector. And then I can go ahead and hit the modify button. And now it's modified. And if you look now at event number two, it is no longer failed. And look at the reflection, minus 74.2. So it's above the detection threshold. It's better than the detection threshold, which is why we didn't measure it. And so now the software knows that what it is. And of course you've added a comment, so that comment's gonna be in there as well, right? So if somebody else views a trace, they'll know why you did it. And anything that you edit will have an asterisk. And then of course we see the little comment here, right? So it has a comment, it has an asterisk. And so that is how you quickly change the event type in EXFO's OTDR software. My name is Kevin Pirries. Thank you very much.